Welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making Gajar Muli Paratha. It's basically carrot and white radish. So the first thing I'm going to prepare is carrot and radish. Here I have big
muli and gajar.
I'm going to peel, wash and shred.
Now look at this, when you peel them, they look so beautiful and the combination of gajar muli is perfect. Here I'm done shredding.
Radish, muli and gajar, carrot. Both of them are shredded and usually what traditional recipe calls for is you add salt and then keep on a counter for about 5-10 minutes and squeeze out all the water. But I don't do that. I just squeeze out this shredded gajar muli without adding salt. I had so many people asking when, by the time they prepare the paratha, it keeps releasing water. So I tried a couple of times and then I came up with something that I don't add salt anymore, but I just squeeze out all the water and then make the mixture. Now there's a trick. Once you make the mixture, you cannot keep it longer. So make sure to mix everything when you are ready to make parathas. Alternatively, you can use boiled mashed aloo or you can use the potato flakes, which is readily available these days in the market. So it will soak water. So those were just few tips when you make parathas. So I'm going to squeeze out some of the water out of this radish, this muli. I'm going to use that water in my dough. One more tip. Once you shred this muli, do not keep it on a counter open, otherwise your kitchen will smell like bad, like it's kind of some killed dead rat and it's very bad. But I mean, once you cook, you will really enjoy this recipe. But that's just a tip. If you are wondering what that smell, where that smell comes from when you make this paratha, so I just would like to inform you, make you aware that that's the smell from this muli. It's a radish. Now, if you can find this Asian radish, you can use the one that's available in market, the small. The outer skin is a purple and inside is white, just like this one. So you can also use that one. That also brings out nice flavor. I tried with that even a couple of times and that tastes amazing. Today I thought of using multigrain flour, so I'm using that and I'm going to add a little bit of salt to flavor it up and mix very well. Here I have a mix of ghee and oil. You can use only oil, you can use only ghee, it's really up to you, but for the best result, sometimes I do this. The other time I would just add a little bit of oil, but with multigrain, this gives me better result. So I'm going to make this crumbly mixture. So here you can see that I got nice crumbly mixture of this flour. Now, as I said that I'm going to use the water out of this muli, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to squeeze out water. You can see that so much of water, even without adding any salt, you can squeeze out so much of water out of this muli radish. And be sure to squeeze out water properly. And I'm going to put this on side. That's all I need. I don't want to add too much flavor of this muli into my dough. Now the rest of the water I'm going to squeeze out in the sink because I don't need that water. Now it is totally optional. If you want to use this water, you can. Otherwise, just use regular water to knead this dough. But it just kind of give a little flavor into your dough as well.
Now I'm going to use the regular water and knead the soft dough, a little bit harder than chapati dough. Dough is ready. You can see that it's nice and soft dough. Now I'm going to smooth out this dough with a little bit oil. This is totally optional step, but I always do this so that when I roll, it's a pleasure experience rolling. It's perfect.
So the dough is ready and I'm going to allow it to rest for about 15-20 minutes. So I'm going to transfer this dough into this bowl and cover it, and in the same bowl I'm going to prepare my stuffing.
So here I have taken into this bowl carrot and radish, and to this I'm going to add red onion. Here I have some coriander leaves, dhania, ginger, garlic and green chili paste. You can add chopped if you wish. This is carom seeds, ajwain, mix of coriander, cumin, dhania-jeera powder, pinch of turmeric, haldi, garam masala, salt to taste. Give it a good mix. Now this is mixed very well, but I forgot to add amchur powder. This is dry mango powder. You can use lemon, but I don't want moisture in my mixture, so I usually prefer to add amchur powder. And this is just a little bit of sugar you can use, or you can leave it out. So mix it again. All right, so this is mixed very well, and I'm going to make lemon size of a ball. So I'm going to make the balls and put it on the side.
Now one more trick to handle the water if it releases more water. When I make the balls, I again squeeze out some water if I feel some more moisture in my mixture. So that will help you to roll them properly. So here I have everything ready now, ready to roll parathas. Here I have rolling board, pin, rolling pin, and I'm using some dry flour to roll them nice. And our dough has been resting for 15-20 minutes now and it's ready. And you can give it a one more knead and it is ready to use. You can see that how nice it gets smooth once you allow it to rest. And I'm going to take a little bit of a bigger than lemon size now. Smooth ball, keep it covered. The dough should be covered at all times. And make a flat ball. Dust into this dry flour and roll. I'm going to roll about 4 inches diameter. And I usually roll the edges a little bit thinner. In middle, I keep it thick. You can make square parathas if you wish. I have already shared how to make a square parathas when I made the paneer paratha. All right, so now ready to put this stuffing in the middle and then gather all the edges in one place and seal very well. And then again, make it flat. Now you can take as much dusting as you need to roll it nice. Rolling this paratha is a bit of a trick, as I said, because it keeps releasing the water. So as soon as you prepare the mixture, try to finish them rolling and baking. So here is how I want to roll. You can keep them thick, you can roll a little bit thinner, it's really up to you. And on the other side, you can see that this is how it looks like. You can see the carrot and the stuffing a little bit, but that's perfectly okay. Now I'm going to show you how to roll square. So just put the stuffing in the middle and then just fold in all sides like this. And then make kind of a square like this. You can see that, and then press and then roll and roll in one direction. So here is our square one. Look at this. And if the stuffing comes out a little bit, don't worry, you can put it back in there and then sprinkle again a little bit more flour and just press it and it's good to go. Now it's time to bake. So here I have this pan I'm going to heat up on a medium heat and bake these parathas. This pan is nice and hot. I'm going to place this paratha and bake on both sides till I get little golden brown specks. First time I'm going to flip it a little bit early, and then on the other side I will allow it to bake a little bit more. So it takes only about a minute to bake on first side, and you can see that the nice golden specks, the small specks, that's perfect. Now it's time to flip on the other side, and you can see that this time can see the big specks, the big brown specks, and I'm going to smear oil. You can bake in ghee, clarified butter, but I simply like oil. The layer comes out crispy with oil, and if you want to bake without any oil or ghee, you can do that too. Now the smell is so good. Sometimes it may puff like this. Paratha is ready, so I'm going to bring it down onto the paper towel here. And look at this paratha, looks so yummy. Same way I'm going to bake this square one. This is my square one. My kids love square paratha. And look at this, it has come out nice and ready to come out again. Here I'm done with making all the parathas, and look at this plate, looks so yummy. And to go with this paratha today, I prepared aloo raita. And here I have this aloo raita. You can watch me making aloo raita in other video. And this is perfect combination. And I can't wait to give it a try here. I'm going to take a little bit into this plate here. Now, the one that I prepared square, you can see that they comes out nice triangle when you cut them from the center. And kids really love this. So I'm going to take that little bit in here and raita. Combination of this aloo raita and gajar muli paratha is like a heaven. Can't tell you how good it is. You have to make it. So this was all about gajar muli paratha, carrot and radish. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.